Welcome back to Logitech. Today I'm gonna review this Ryzen 5 5500. Well, it might be a little bit late for me to review this Ryzen 5500 because it launched 2 months ago. But I don't have time since I'm working 7 days a week, so I just have time to review this 5500 right now. Okay, let's just see what is inside this box and we do the processor benchmark and also the gaming benchmark. First, I test using CPU-Z. Single core performance is much slower than 5600X and 1200F. Multitask score is not far with 5600X, but still 10% slower than 12400F. Next is Cinebench R23. Ryzen 5500 consume less power than 5600X and 1200F. However, the temperature is highest compared to other with the same cooler. The multitask score is not much different than 5600X. However, 1200F still 17% faster while having coolest temperature compared to others. Now moving to the gaming benchmark. I test with 3080 Ti 1080p Ultra setting. First game is Forza Horizon 4. The gap is really big. 5600X still about 20% faster and 1200F is 26% faster than Ryzen 5500. The next game I test is Horizon Zero Dawn. 5600X and 1200F don't have much difference in here except 1% low. But compared to 5500, 1200F still about 15% faster. The last game I test is Shadow of Tomb Raider. Another huge gap between 5500 and others. The other processor is about 20% faster than Ryzen 5500. Now I will do the overclocking for this processor. With my ASRock B550 Pro 4, I managed to get 4.6 GHz with 1.3 × 1 V. I cannot get any higher frequency stable than 4.6 GHz. Okay, let's just do the benchmark of the overclocking. In CPU-Z, 5500 OC scored 12% faster in single core and 6.5% faster in multi-core compared to the stock, but still unable to beat 1200F. In Cinebench R23, my overclock setting consume about 76 watt, which still a little lower than 5600X stock before. However, the temperature reach about 78 degrees Celsius with same cooler. 5500 OC score 9% better now, but still cannot reach 1200F with almost same price. Now moving to gaming benchmark. The setting is still the same like non-OC test. First game is Forza Horizon 4. Unlike the CPU test, Ryzen 5500 at 4.6 GHz only 3% better than stock setting and still far below 1200F. Next game I test is Horizon Zero Dawn. The improvement is only about 2.3% compared to the stock. When you play, you won't notice anything. And the last game is Shadow of Tomb Raider. The improvement in this game is the highest compared to other games. 5500 OC is almost 5% faster than the stock, but still not close to 1200F. From the benchmark review just now, this Ryzen 5500 is not as I expected. It's much slower than this Core i5-12400F. Currently, the different price of this Ryzen 5500 and Core i5-12400F in my place is about 18 bucks. But the performance is significantly different. In multitask core itself, this Core i5-12400F is almost 20% faster than this 5500, and in single core it's more than 20% faster. This Ryzen 5500 is only support PCIe Gen 3, so if you have NVMe Gen 4, it will not detected with this processor. Or maybe if you have the motherboard supporting Gen 4, it will only running up to Gen 3. Well, it's like a downgrade from 3000 series, which is support Gen 4. I think this 5500 is just cut off from 5600G, which is like a 5600G without iGPU. Talking about 5600G, we know in my old review, the 5600G is much hotter than 5600X. It's not different with this 5500. It's still much hotter than the Ryzen 5600X. This 5500 only consume about 67 watt, while this Ryzen 5600X consume about 78 watt. But the temperature, this 5500 is much hotter than this 5600X. When I overclock it, it reach about 78 degrees Celsius with the same cooler. Compared to Core i5-12400F, it's not even reach 60 degrees Celsius, which is much more different in the temperature. Okay, now let's talk about the advantage of this Ryzen 5500. First is, when we see the gaming benchmark, this 5500 is running like an Intel processor. It consumes much less power than this Ryzen 5600X, since it will boost all core up to 4.25 GHz and then limit the power consumption based on the CPU usage. It's similar like what Intel do. The other plus of this processor is, you don't need to upgrade your motherboard to buy this processor. Well, not all 300 motherboard series support this processor, even though they said it support in the latest BIOS. I already tried in the Gigabyte AB350 Gaming 3. I update to the latest BIOS, it say it support 5500, but it didn't boot. It only flash 1 second in the Gigabyte logo and then off. So, in the 300 series, it not guaranteed supporting 5000 series. Maybe if you upgrade for 400 series motherboard, it will more stable. And the last plus of this 5500 is the overclocking. The overclocking headroom is pretty good. The stock is only running about 4.25 GHz all cores, but I can manage to overclock up to 4.6 GHz. Well, maybe it because silicon lottery. Getting to the conclusion, this Ryzen 5500 is only good if you upgrading for 1000 series processor or 2000 series processor. If you already have Zen 2 3000 series processor, I don't think the performance is much different, and also Zen 2 is already support PCIe Gen 4, while this one is cut off of 5600G and only support PCIe Gen 3. If you going to build a new PC, Ryzen currently doesn't have any product that can have good performance per value compared to Intel. Like example, this 5500 and this 1200F only costs about 15 to 20 bucks difference, and the performance is significantly better and also faster in gaming. If you going to build a new PC with Ryzen processor, I think you need to wait until Zen 4 launch. This 5500 is not a good option for you if you want to build a new PC gaming. Currently, Intel have really good value if you want to build a new PC. Well, that's all from me. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. And don't forget to check the link in the description below. Thanks for watching.